Well, welcome to Match 18 in the Simzanzi Super League for 2018. It's the Paarl Rocks, the home side, up against the Durban Heat. Earlier, just confirmation of the toss, and Duplessis, the home captain, flicking the coin. Albie Morkel calling correctly and having no hesitation in electing to bat first. That's how they stack up, the Paarl Rocks and the Durban Heat. Neil Manthorpe alongside. Manners, what do you make of those two sides today?
Pressure on Durban Heat, and really interesting to see that Hashim Amla's been left out, the marquee player. He, Proteas star, has been struggling for runs. So no Hashim Amla today, no Temba Bavuma either. But an opportunity for Cyril Avia at the top of the order to show us what he's made of. And for the Paarl Rocks, and again, I mean, it's been a hit and miss start to the campaign for them, but on home soil, in front of their adoring home crowd, on that surface, Alistair, which you had a closer look at earlier, I think you'd probably have to back the home side favourites.
All right, we're ready to rock and roll here. Bjorn Fortein to bowl the first over.
Oh, that's a decent shout.
Up in the air, over short fine, and that's the first boundary for the Durban Heat. Oh, great shot. Morne van Wyk at his best. Delicate touch. Past the short third man. Welcome boundary for Morne.
That's four runs. That's the reverse sweep that we were talking about. Oh, that's very sweet. Straight out of the middle, and the first maximum of the Durban Heat innings. That was a poor delivery and a rare one from Bjorn Fortein.
Yeah, he's jumped all over this, Cyril Avia. It was slightly short. He rocked back and got it right out the middle of the bat. Nobody out there. Kept the form nicely. Kept the hands firm through the ball. Goes again. Should be another boundary. Fine leg up in the circle, and he's got it up and over him and runs away for four. Terrific over this.
Oh, great shot again by Cyril Avia. Picking up the length so quickly, is he?
And that'll be another boundary. Trying the slower ball bouncer, David Visa. Doesn't get it right, and Morne van Wyk able to paddle it around the corner. 50 up for the Durban Heat.
Oh, great shot again by Cyril Avia. Another maximum there by the big lad. He's putting pedal to the metal now, is Cyril.
He's looking to be aggressive. That one was in the slot. Better hit, quite full, half volley. You have to say slower ball, some pace taken off it. Avia showing his strength. Good timing.
Oh, it's bowled him. Great delivery by Grant Thompson.
He's got one to sneak through the gate, maybe with the help of a little inside edge, but he is so stoked with that. And the Durban Heat lose their in batsman, Cyril Avia, gone for 32, 65 for one now. It's a really good shot. You'd have to say, not a great delivery. Full, wide, able to free the arms and smash it through the offside for four.
Oh, great shot. And that's a wicket for Tabriz Shamsi. Oh no, what has he got going here? Stand by for the phone call. Not coming today, unfortunately.
Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No. It is Tabriz Shamsi with the Superman neck scarf, it looks like. He knew straight away, and I think Morne van Wyk was resigned to his fate as well. He got up very slowly, and there it came. So the skull scarf, I'm led to believe. Anyway, a different celebration. Morne van Wyk gone for 33, 78 for two now.
Get!
Yeah! Got him. Caught at mid-wicket. Bjorn Fontaine has another one. Faf du Plessis doesn't drop too many. And if he can get a hand to it, you'd back Faf du Plessis to hang on. And another failure for David Miller. But Bjorn Fontaine continues his successful campaign for the Pole Rocks, and that's a massive blow.
Yeah, the bad run continues straight to Faf du Plessis. Just had to dive just slightly to his right. Another wicket goes down.
Durban Heat, 81 for three. David Miller's gone for a single. Got him. What a good catch. Well, that's very well bowled. Kept it full and straight, did Chepo Marecki, and he's got his man. Very well judged down at long on by Henry Davids. And Heinrich Klaassen has to go for a disappointing 4 from 9.
Yeah, unfortunately, feeling the pressure there, Heinrich Klaassen. Went for the big shot, but catch in the end by Henry Davids. Fortunately, Durban Heat in a spot of bother. He goes for 4 of 9 balls. Durban Heat, 89-4.
When a bowler's turning it both ways, oh dear me. I was going to say, when a bowler's turning it both ways, it helps as a batsman when he bowls you a full toss, but it doesn't help for the fielding side. That's Grant Thompson, who's made a bit of a mess of this one. Every run so important. And there was a nasty bobble. There had to be. Had his eyes on the ball. And, Shamsi is disappointed, understandably, about that.
Yes, yes, yes!
He's got him. Mangalisa Mosetli reacting quickly from behind the stumps. The reverse sweep not working out.
That's a big wicket, Albie Mwoko. We know how dangerous he can be, especially at the back end. Try the reverse sweep again, gets the top edge. And a nice, easy catch for Mosetli. Shamsi bowled really well today. Gets another breakthrough. Struggling now, the Durban Heat really struggling. They lose a fifth wicket, 105 for 5. Albie Mwoko gone for 8.
That's better. Down the ground, that'll be a boundary. Really good shot from Kaya Zondo.
That every now and then, you give the batsman credit, and that was beautifully played. Bernard Philander knew where the fielders were, knew how to beat them. Did it perfectly.
That's bludgeoned away. It'll go to the boundary for 4, yeah. Fielder won't get around. The man in the circle, it covers very square. And mid-off, not able to cover the ground and make the save. Excellent strike. That's up in the air, dropped. Should have been taken. Kaya Zondo trying to force one up and over the infield. Didn't get all of it, spliced it. And really, you'd have to think that it should have been pouched.
It was Henry Davids underneath. Gosh, that was an unusual lapse from the Boyland man, Titans man. He'd been up there for 10 years, but this is his very, very much his home territory. It's another slow ball bouncer attempted by Dane Patterson, and that was exactly the over that the Durban Heat really needed. There you go, Vernon Philander's got one over deep backward square leg, and that's gone all the way for 6. Just waits a bit, delays. Very, very well played.
Yeah, shortish boundary out there over square leg, just 67 metre carry. And that doesn't matter. You don't get more runs for the further it goes back past the boundary. 6 more. Oh, is that spot on? Right in the block hole. Excellent execution of the Yorker from David Visa.
That's better. Bad Yorker. Gets middle stump. That's a big breakthrough. These two are looking a bit dangerous. Philander gone for 30. Did a nice job though. 154 for six.
Where the T20 game is these days, that's below par score. Very well bowled. That is beautifully bowled by David Visa. A perfect Yorker right up in the block hole and a dot ball to finish the innings. Durban Heat winning the toss and batting first. They've made 154 for six. You would think that is below par, considerably below par. But this is a team desperately in need of victory. Sometimes desperation can work in a team's favour.
Overs 5 to 15 really let them down. Too many wickets fell. And there you have it. Miller, Klaas and Morkel gone for single figures. And it was left to Philander and Kaya Zondor to try and rescue the innings. Philander, a little cameo, 30 of 16. And in the end, off their allotted 20 overs, 154 for 6 is where the Durban Heat will end up.
14, just got one wicket of 25, didn't finish his overs. Patterson started off really well in his first two overs, so got a bit of tap at the end. Shamsi was a standout of the bowlers, four overs, for 20, and the two wickets. And then Visa and Thompson got one apiece. So all in all, I think they'll be really happy with their job. Started off badly, but brought it back quite nicely.
So the Pole Rocks keep their hopes of a playoff match at least alive. Will need 155 off their 20 overs at an asking rate of a wee bit under 8 to the over. History will tell us that you've always got a chance if you get over 150. But Henry Davids and Aidan Markram won't be doing anything too rash. You're not, I don't think, going to see them looking consciously to make a flying start. If it happens, then all good. They just don't want to lose early wickets. Here's Kyle Abbott. I think that's confirmation of that. Leave. The least common shot in T20 cricket these days is the leave. Oh, that's a fine shot. Just a little bit too much width from Vernon Philander, which was exaggerated by Aidan Markram. The slap cut shot.
He's gone. Henry Davids is not comfortable here, and I think that this might be the end of him. He pulled up very smartly. I was just watching him off screen, and I tell you what, he's in the world of hurt.
It's completely your fault, Alistair Campbell. A moment ago, he walked out to bat, and you said 37 going on 38 and still as fit as a fiddle. And look what you've done. He's gone in the fetlock, hasn't he? What is that? Thigh? Hamstring?
Judging by his condition, I'm not sure that he'll be back anytime soon. That looks a pretty serious injury to Henry Davids.
Wrong line. Too straight. Fine leg is up in the circle.
That's very, very well played from Aidan Markram. He's looking to get underneath Kyle Abbott whenever he possibly can. It's a risk-reward situation for the batsman, just as it is for the bowlers. So that's a terrific shot. Marvellous from Fuff du Plessis. Terrific footwork. That's what enabled Aidan Markram to get to the pitch of the ball. Really quick feet.
Ah, terrific shot. It's on the up. It's not a half volley. It's a decent delivery. He's run up and hit a length. And he stood up and hit it on the top of the bounce down the ground. That's in the gap and will run away for four. Another sublime piece of placement and timing from Fuff du Plessis. Got him, bowled him. Excellent stuff from the young man. He's had the last laugh. He was under pressure on the high felt, but here in Pearl today, with Aidan Markram looking good, looking to dominate, he's come up trumps.
He gets the breakthrough. Slow ball. Off cutter. Hit a bit low, actually, and gets the big wicket of Aidan Markram. They've lost their first wicket. The umpire actually wants to check the Frankfurt quickly, just to confirm. As Markram waits to see. Oh, that's a big one. That is a big one.
I'll tell you what, he was pushing the line the other night, and I think on impact, something has to be behind the line. Just to remind all your viewers at home, there's nothing behind the line there, and it's going to be called no ball, I reckon, and Aidan Markram is going to get a reprieve. Oh, my word, what have you done, Bokako? Such a huge wicket, and you've overstepped. And to add insult to injury, it'll be a free hit as well. Well back, well back. At least not too much damage done. So the 50 partnership between these two of just 38 deliveries. Major contribution from Aidan Markram of 41.
Oh, yes, that's very well bowled. Brandon Mavuta has his man. We're just talking about the quality of play against spin, but Aidan Markram maybe taking his eye off the ball there. He just did it keep a bit low from Brandon Mavuta. It was the regulation leg break, and Markram stranded well out of his ground, furious with himself. Yet another excellent start from Aidan Markram. Markram gone for 48.
Oh, great shot by Faf du Plessis. Mavuta over pitches. Faf du Plessis up to the task. Great boundary there for the Paul Rocks.
Catch! Oh. That's another beautiful shot. Picked his spot and has found it. The gap at extra cover. He's just got a little bit too straight as Albie Morkel. He knows it, turns away in disgust immediately. No point watching that one travel down to the boundary.
Great shot again. Bit of width and offer from Albie Morkel. Faf du Plessis once again up to the task. Another boundary for the Paul Rocks. He moves to 42 of 29. That brings up the 100 for the Paul Rocks.
Was in the air for quite a while, but in the gap. Another really good over here for the Paul Rocks. Two boundaries. 10 runs off this one.
It looks like the master plan of Faf really has worked out today. Very happy with your bowling performance, especially Shamsi.
Absolutely, it looks like a good wicket. I don't think it's a 200 wicket like we've had in the past, but we were happy to keep them under 150 after their start. They had a very good start, and then we pegged them back with a few wickets, and then they couldn't quite accelerate at the end like they'd like to. I think Vernon batted very well at the end, but they've got a target there, but it's going well for the moment, but we got to see it through all the way.
Yeah, so much has been said about the heat being under pressure, but we know the Rocks also feeling it a bit. Adrian, thank you so much for that. All the best of luck for the remaining stanza of the show. Let's go back to our team. It looks like more and more action going down on the field behind us.
Well, I tell you what, there hasn't been a ball hit harder today. That went very quickly through Temba Bavuma at extra cover and away to the boundary for four.
Death touch there by Vaughan van Asfalt. Ben Philander doing the cleanup work there, but three runs nevertheless.
Well done, Vernon!
Good partnership here by one for Nelsfeld and Faf du Plessis. 54 of 39 balls. And a wicket, a dot ball, different ball game again with two overs to go. Up in the air. lands safely just over the man of long on, David Miller.
Just got enough on it, right off the bottom of the bat. His heart would have been in his mouth for a millisecond there, Fuff du Plessis. But in the end, clearing David Miller, running backwards by 2 or 3 yards.
Looking for the big one, and he's got it. He's got that boundary they've been looking for. That's going to ease any sort of pressure they were feeling. Just 5 needed now.
Scores level with an over to go. Again, Fuff du Plessis picking his spot, knew where he wanted to hit it. Scores level, 19 overs gone, 1 remaining. Kyle Abbott bowl a maiden. No, he won't. That's heaved over the top and it just trickles into the boundary rope. And there's a hug for Vaughan van Jaarsveld from Captain Fuff du Plessis. Jaarsveld moves on to 28 and will finish on 28 from 23 balls. Fuff du Plessis 76, and the Pile Rocks have won by 9 wickets with 5 balls to spare.
Emphatic victory by Pile Rocks. By 9 wickets. A partnership there by du Plessis and van Jaarsveld. 82 of 52 balls. The finishing shot there from Vaughan van Jaarsveld. Pumps the air. He'll be pretty pleased with getting his team over the line. That puts the Pile Rocks now in a playoff position. Still have another game this afternoon. But they'll be pretty pleased with that victory.
Fuff du Plessis leading his team through to their third victory, with Aidan Markram having contributed 48 and poor old Henry Davids being forced to retire after the first over with a strained groin muscle. So a comprehensive victory in the end. Just the 5 deliveries to spare and a thankless day for the bowlers. Only Zimbabwean leg spinner Brandon Mavuta with a wicket to show for his efforts. Bernard Philander just bowled the 2 overs.